Easy, Colonel, easy.
Can't bear to look, and I can't bear not to look.
Believe me, ladies, once this temptation has been removed, it will be as though a great weight had been lifted from you.
I do feel a heaviness in the heart to change this room, to send away Papa's things. Oh, sister.
You hold your horses there now a minute, gentlemen.
Oh, Mr. Walton. What a lovely surprise.
You kindly lay your burden down, men.
This is a family matter, Walton, and no concern of yours.
It is a concern of mine. These lovely ladies are treasured friends of mine since their girlhood, and I'm not one to stand idly by and watch a conniver walk away with their happy inheritance, cousin or no cousin.
The ladies have seen a new light.
You mean, excuse me, Miss Mamie, you mean the light from this star?
As a matter of fact, yes. That star came smashing from the heavens like a great fiery fist destroying the wellsprings of wickedness.
But it didn't. That's the point. He did not smash or destroy one thing. That star came millions of miles from God knows where, and I say that reverently, to fall through your roof and land here on the floor. And it did not destroy or graze one thing in this wellspring of friendliness or smash one single jar in these well-stocked shelves.
Oh, sister, that is true.
Yes, it is.
I am through looking for signs in the course of nature. A maple tree drops its leaves doesn't mean the old tree is dead. And a fallen star is a fallen star. And if we make anything more of it, it's our fault, not the stars. And my boy here, he convinced me we can think ourselves into anything. And that is my thinking.
The warning is perfectly clear.
Why, that star just nestled in here just as light as a feather and landed here, and if it did bring any kind of a message, it was enjoy, not destroy.
Oh, yes, Mr. Walton, that's exactly the message Sister and I received.
And the message that come through was not one of sinfulness or wickedness. It was the star wished to find a lovely, happy home to make its landing in, and what could be more appropriate than the Baldwin place?
Oh, Mr. Walton, Papa himself could not have said it better.
Well, you are making a terrible mistake, ladies. I am shocked that you would let an outsider come between Baldwins.
Oh, Cousin Polonius, Sister and I both know that you're concerned only with what is best for us.
Then you must not be influenced by a stranger.
I spoke to Sheriff Bridges on the way over.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He did say he's come by to see the star in a few minutes, didn't he?
Oh, how very nice. Well, now, where's Colonel Henderson going, Cousin Polonius?
We have several important transactions pending in the capital. It is obvious that our efforts to be of help here are a waste of time. Ladies?
Sister, I do fear we have offended Cousin Polonius.
Don't be alarmed, ladies. As I recall it, Cousin Polonius is of very forgiving nature.
At any rate, Papa's recipe machine is safe.
I think this is an occasion that requires a celebration with some of the recipe made by Papa himself.
Oh, sister, the 1925 or the 1927?
Well, let's have a little of both.
Mr. Wall, 25. Yes, Mr. Wall, yours is the first.
I'll take the 27.
Yes,